come the weekend.
Yeah. So it's back. We've been waiting less than 3 days to go till all that bitching and fighting and tears and tantrums and the odd bit of singing, of course, starts all over again. X Factor is back this Saturday.
And along with Mr. Carl and a stellar judging lineup, we've got Jeff Breezer, who had access all areas.
So he's backstage.
Well, he finds out what they all really think of each other. Never mind the newspapers. Mm. Here it is.
The distance between that entrance and this spot is roughly about 20 feet, but it represents one of the most agonising walks in showbiz today. Appropriately enough, X marks the spot where a contestant will face one of the toughest judging panels in talent show history. Simon, Cheryl, Mel and Louis will decide if that contestant has got the X Factor. Yes, the show that has created huge stars, huge bust-ups, not to mention huge emotions. Any time, Ryland. Sorry, we're gonna have to crack on.
3, 2, 1, cue them in.
Yes, the X Factor is back, with stalwart Louis Walsh seeing the return of Mel B, Cheryl Fernandez-Versini, and Mr. Nasty himself, Simon Cowell.
OK, judges, are we ready?
Yeah.
Let's see our first act of the day.
I can't believe that I'm sitting in front of the X Stock with Simon Cowell, with Louis Walsh. Are you looking forward to today's auditions?
Yeah, I think so. I'm just looking through the list here. This is the list we get.
Is this how it works? So it's all planned?
Yeah.
They don't just come in off the street and walk straight into the audition room, do they?
No, so we've got a bit of information about what songs they're going to sing. You can sometimes see by their songs they've chosen there's going to be a terrible
be like.
Audition, but always hope for the best.
And once the acts have received their judgment,
okay, imagine the biggest blackboard in the world and you've got 8 people drawing their nails down it. Times 10. That's how irritating you were.
Really?
The next stop is Mr. Dermot O'Leary. What is this place?
This is where the hugs happen.
OK. So this is after I've just come out.
You've just done a very
good
audition.
I've just come out of this door.
Yeah.
Right, judges' room is behind those scary judges. Oh, my God, I think I've done all right. They've put me through.
Yeah.
And there you are.
Boom.
How would you...
With you, I'd go a manly handshake and then
Why would you go handshake first?
I wouldn't want to get any
makeup.
There's a bit of makeup transfer between the two of us quite easily there.
Okay, I can take a hint. And talking of hints, there's no notes, there's no little heads up from production like,
no,
really good. That's for you to clearly judge and make up for your own mind.
We have to work it out.
I don't like to know anything. We had a girl who came in yesterday who turned out to be Robert Patterson's sister. And actually, they didn't tell us, in fact, she didn't tell us till afterwards.
Yeah.
Which was a bit annoying.
That surprised me, because I thought you'd know absolutely everything at this point. But
don't like to know.
But it's more fair that way, I guess.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. Plus, of course, it would ruin the surprise. And new Extra Factor presenter.
Well, Dermot does the cuddles, I do the high fives.
Sarah Jane Crawford assures me there are plenty of those in store. It really does take all sorts to make an X Factor audition day, doesn't it? I've noticed that there is...
You're down here for a start.
Whatever. There is the Supremes with Elvis, is that right?
Yes.
Did you see them?
There was an actual black Elvis, which I love, and two of the Supremes, and I think it's a mother and two daughters. So that's just amazing. Only on X Factor.
Only on X Factor. Also, only on The X Factor, the return of the artist formerly known as Cheryl Cole. Ladies, I feel a bit under pressure because what the viewers can't see, there's about 800 cameras. Is this what it's like for you the whole time that you're filming The X Factor auditions?
It's like I've never been gone, to be honest, but I don't focus on them. I focus on the contestants and then whoever's asking the questions, if she's not distracting us.
Is she a bit of a distraction?
Yes, she's naughty. I'm the crazy,
stupid love. While Mel is a little bit naughty, newly married Cheryl was being a little bit twerky for her last video, Crazy Stupid Love, which saw her storming the charts once again. So I wondered what brought her back to the X Factor.
It wasn't something I had in the pipeline, but honestly, I couldn't take any more of the begging from Cheryl.
Let's talk about the grovelling. What kind of grovelling was it?
I mean, it was pretty intense.
How did he make it known? Was it text messages? Was it flowers?
It was all of the above, yeah.
Just barraged you.
So I thought, you know what? Let me just do you a favour.
Get him off my case.
No, do you know what? It felt right. I've always loved the show. I needed time off, that's for sure. But I was ready to come back, and now that I'm back, it's like I've never been gone.
I think people are ready for you. People are ready for you. Well, I'm not sure if they're ready for you.
I'm not sure either.
With your direct longbow, honestly.
Yes, it seems once scary, always scary. Remember these classic moments?
I found it all a little bit irritating. Overdoing the comedic personality thing, I found that irritating.
I completely disagree with that.
There's a major broadsheet that said you don't critique nicely. You machine gun people to pieces.
You look like a pop star.
Thank you.
You don't sound like one.
That was a bit harsh, Mel.
I'm just honest, and I'm just me. I don't prep anything. I just, what I see, I just react. I'm very kind of spontaneous.
I'll probably break down and cry.
The dance routine was lazy and sloppy, and one of you were doing it half-assed.
Can we do another song?
No.
She's just direct.
Honest.
She says things I probably think, but the words just get stuck. I can't get them out of my mouth.
Is there a part of you, Cheryl, that would like to be a little bit more honest, like Mel?
I think
you're honest,
I'm
too.
I'm honest.
Yeah, you are.
But like, Mel's just a bit more direct.
I'm hanging out on Monday.
Direct to the judges now. The next really, really posh Spice. To
try. I like your posh accent.
Oh, I had a scholarship to a boarding school.
And where are you from?
I'm from England.
I feel like I'd hate to audition. I've been out there, I stood on the X, and it's intimidating, even when there's nobody in the room.
Yeah.
How do you think you'd be as an auditionee?
I think as long as I could sing, I think I'd be all right. I think the most important thing is, if I'm brutally honest, it's to surprise the judges. And so many people come in and do, I don't know, if they're a young girl, or do a Rihanna song or an Adele song, and you sort of, you feel for them, but you want someone to just take them to one side and go, what are you doing? Because you're only going to get compared to Rihanna. Whereas, you know, when people come in that are almost a step ahead, and they'll do, you know, they'll rework a song that, you know, might be only, we had a girl the other day sing The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air with a guitar, and it was really stripped back, and you wouldn't have seen it coming a mile off. And yet, it was the last audition of yesterday, so we finished filming at 1 o'clock in the morning. Everyone's tired, and she came in, and it was one of the best auditions of the day.
It worked.
Brilliant, brilliant.
Right, there's no one else around. I've always wanted to do this. This is what it feels like to be Simon Cowell and hold the destiny of each individual contestant completely in his hands. Right, he also holds these in his hands because they're right under his desk, so these must be his. He obviously likes a sweet. Lots of Snickers, Milky Way. I think if you put a Malteser in there, that's your job gone. Shall I take one? Tempting. Nah, it's a potential career ender. I'm off, quick.
See you in part two tomorrow. We'll be right back.